Bernard Shaw said, "Nothing is worth doing unless the consequences may be serious." He also said, "When a thing is funny, search it carefully for a hidden truth."
At the Little Penis That Could, a podcast and a cartoon series, we are crazy about democracy. This brilliant edited Coinbase commercial and our shows are meant to inspire the next generations of world leaders. Bon appetit. Stay hungry, my friends, and a share of the peanuts.
It's called a bicycle, but will anybody ride it?
Organize international online community nations and use the internet for change? Why? Everything is great, right?
The automobile is here, but horses are here to stay.
Elevator? What's wrong with using the stair?
Young people, become world leaders? The world's youth would never unite online. They're too lazy and immature to impact world issues. Right?
A telephone? Who would actually use that?
People said it was not possible to fly through the air.
It's unclear if commercial air travel will ever take off.
Flying over the Atlantic.
I give you a go to launch, Artemis 1.
We're on our way, Houston.
Do we really need personal computer?
Women. Women can't lead an international online nation. That's absurd. Corrupt old white men will always lead the world. Right?
No one actually used that.
A so-called information superhighway.
No. Why'd she take
first? I'll never shop online.
Credit cards on the internet.
The web is full of scams.
Come on, electric vehicles will never happen.
I know that you won't believe it, but the highest form of human excellence is to question oneself and others.
All penis characters and events are from my dreams, even those based on real people. All are impersonated poorly and thus fictional. Do not permit our pot to come into your ears if you are allergic to the penis, as various illnesses, including death, may occur. The following programs should not be heard or viewed by anyone.
If you would like to win $150 in cash, be the first person to type the correct 12-word answer to this question in our comments below. What can be more politically, socially, and militarily influential and powerful than military war and nuclear weapons? The answer is 12 words that begin with the word "the," and you can only submit up to 3 answers. Also, if you prefer a still humorous, yet more serious journey into our ideas to protect and save world democracy, skip to 15 minutes, 12 seconds in our show.
Buongiorno! Do current world situations find you clenching your sphincter tighter than a skeeter's ass in a nosedive? At the Little Peanuts That Could, the podcast and the cartoon series, we think we have the answers and solutions to protecting and saving world democracies and our climate, and thus, relaxing your uptight to sphincter. Welcome to the relaunch of the Little Peanuts That Could podcast and cartoon series, including our sketch called Between the Two Peanuts, with my Swami, Ashfaq. We're currently relaunching our first 10 shows, plus the best of Swami Ashfaq's quotes and the best of our funniest and hardest-hitting commercials.
And now, the best breaking and broken news segments in the industry. Breaking news, folks. Reports indicate that viewership at CNN is dropping faster than any previous news network since 4 weeks ago, when the fucks that they fucks the news announced their ratings were dropping faster than a legitimate attorney's reputation while representing fucks or Trump. Because of CNN chasing Fox News ratings through the sewer like a cocaine crocodile, CNN has decided to drop a former president and CEO, Chris Licht, faster than Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas dropped any vestiges of a law-abiding ethics and integrity within the Supreme Court. Now, this has provided an excellent opportunity for us at PNN, the Penis News Network, to capitalize on the ouster of CNN's seemingly disgraced former president and CEO, Mr. Licht. This has allowed us to make this stunning and disruptive industry announcement. At the former PNN, the Penis News Network, where we deliver the news like every news anchor in the world would like to, please allow me to introduce to you the new PNN, LPNN, the Lick to Penis News Network, and our new slogan, We'll Keep You Coming. Now, in our interviews with Mr. Lick, he has expressed remorse and a strong desire to redeem himself, along with what can only be described as a primal desire to join our Penis News Network. As you can imagine, it was an easy alphabetical decision to announce our Lick to Penis News Network versus the alternative, the Penis Lick to News Network. If you would like to assist in expanding our market penetrations, please share our breaking and broken news segments as much as possible, as I think we can all agree that the world will be waiting with bated breath in anticipation of the Lick to Penis News Network, where we'll keep you coming. Breaking news from the Lick to Penis News Network. World-renowned climate activist and champion of autistics, Greta Thunberg announces the end of her Friday school boycotts due to her graduating from high school. When asked about her future plans, Thunberg said she would be launching her new Eat Penis Not Wieners campaign with international champion of justice, Gorgeous George Clooney, and the social entrepreneurship guru, fellow Nobel Prize winner Muhammad Yunus. When asked why she was so anti-wiener, Thunberg said, and I quote, "In the fight to prevent catastrophic and irreversible climate change, we must dramatically reduce the consumption of meat, and that obviously includes eating a lot less wieners." Thunberg continued by saying, "When I heard that Muhammad Yunus and the Gorgeous George Clooney were collaborating to sell his tasty little penis for charities, I decided to help them, as that would also help in the fight to prevent catastrophic climate change. Plus," she said, "Mr. Yunus and I, who have both won the Nobel Prize, we agree it would be freaking cool if Gorgeous George Clooney wins the Nobel Prize for selling his tasty little penis for charities and to save our climate and world democracy." As expected, Thunberg concluded her interview by proclaiming, "Please help my friend Professor Yunus, my other friend Anonymous B, and I prank Gorgeous George Clooney into selling his penis for charities. And remember, eat peanuts, not wieners."
Broken news, folks. A team of a reptile scientists from the Bartali Manaconda Institute, the Bartali Institute of Manaconda and Minuscule, Tube Snake Endurance and Discovery, are responsible for this story, which must be seen to be believed. Now, this discovery was courageously and with attention to every minute, or should we say minuscule detail, led by Professor Stormy Daniels, who is proud to announce the discovery in Indonesia of a new manaconda species, the Phallus serpentus repentus, the bald-headed giggle snake. Holy shlongapole! What a beautiful creature of God that is. Now this insanely familiar looking creature, especially to Professor Daniels, bears uncanny resemblance to another previously unknown and yet much smaller relative, the smallest snake not relegated to worm status, the FlaccidusMushroomusMinisculusDonaldus, which was also discovered by Professor Daniels after hours of searching and repeated attempts with the tweezers. Now, Professor Daniels, who has had an illustrious and bodacious serpent goddess career as the snake-worshipping scientist known best for her deep and vigorous video research into tube snakes. She rose to fame upon discovering FlaccidusMushroomusMinisculusDonaldus in America, where her first words upon finally sighting that little booger have been well documented by going viral when she exclaimed, and I quote, "That's the smallest tube snake I've ever seen." Now, Professor Daniels, whose research includes her diligence in documenting tube snake endurance, she told us that the Phallus serpentus repentus, the bald-headed giggle snake, is known for its endurance, as it can slither for extended periods and routinely exceeded all current known endurance records. Now, conversely, the FlaccidusMushroomusMinisculusDonaldus, which is also lovingly known across the world as a two-pump-a-donny, has been determined to be the least vigorous of tube snakes, despite its small length and circumference. Professor Daniels has determined that this inability to perform is likely because the FlaccidusMushroomusMinisculusDonaldus is incapable of lifting its disproportionately large mushroom head from the ground, no matter how much stimulation it receives, and thus can only achieve two of its each worm low pumps. After which, Tupumpadani lies for an extended time in a flaccid and exhausted state. Now, because of this, Professor Daniels unequivocally determined that the FlaccidusMushroomusMinisculusDonaldus has the least endurance of any tube snake she has ever documented during her career.
And now, another one of our great commercials.
Buongiorno. Do you find yourself with an itchy penis? Do your nuts smell as if they're moldy or rotting? My name is Dr. Gino Bartali from the Psoriatic Bloated Scrotus Institute, and I'm the inventor of Dr. Gino's Bloated Scrotum Aromatically Enhanced Penis Infection Cream. Whether your dangling darlings are smelling like a decaying walrus or itching as if infected by the fleas of a thousand camels, all you need to do is generously apply and massage Dr. Gino's Bloated Scrotus Aromatically Enhanced Penis Infection Cream into your nuts. And in moments, your better half will be saying, "Mamma mia, that's an effervescent penis." Warning, do not massage our cream onto your penis if excessively swollen, if you're allergic to aromatically enhanced penis infection creams, or if your nutsack is perforated, as hospitalizations and the death may occur. Should you experience lightheartedness, throbbing, additional swelling, or unusual secretions from your penis, contact your doctor. And don't forget to visit itchypenis.com and enter the promo code NUTS and receive 25% off your first order.
Buongiorno, Mr. Gorgeous George Clooney. Dr. Gino Bartali here again from the Little Penis That Could podcast and the cartoon series, where we intend to prank you into selling your audaciously tasty, juicy, and nutritious little penis of positivities for charities and to save world democracies. As you can see, I am reading my latest handwritten letter just for you. I wanted you to know that every night when I go to bed and every morning I wake up, I have visions, patriotic Americans. They share messages for you through me, Dr. Gino Bartali. Dr. Martin Luther King He keeps telling me that you should give a speech from the Lincoln Memorial called I Have a Penis. I think that would be a pretty good speech, don't you? And the Teddy Roosevelt, he wants me to tell you to walk softly and carry a little penis.
And now, we introduce you to Between Two Penis.
Buongiorno, folks. And welcome to Between the Two Penis, where I, Dr. Gino Bartali, interview various penisettes in the discussion of how to save and promote worldwide democracies. On today's show, we are so proud to introduce to you Maharishi Matthew from the Church of the Untethered and the Tasty Penis.
Tasty Penis.
Maharishi Matthew, it is so nice to see you, my friend. And welcome to Between the Two Penis. I know that you had expressed some interest or questions regarding the idea of preserving and saving world democracies with international online nations, ion nations, as the way of uniting the world around democracy. What questions would you like to ask me? Between two pinks.
What is an international, online, democratic nation?
Maharishi Matthew, we at the Little Penis That Could.com only offer ideas so as to inspire the growth and progress of democracy. We can do nothing but share ideas that may be considered. Our only recommendation is that the movement abide by the teachings of famed futurist Buckminster Fuller when he said, "Dare to be naive. We are intended to be architects of the future, not its victims. Don't fight forces. Use them. You never change things from within. To change something, build a new model that makes the previous model obsolete." At the Little Penis That Could, we propose that the youth of the world, women of the world, people of color of the world, and others unite online as independent yet aligned democratic nations. We also propose these independent yet aligned nations organize and govern from universities worldwide, aligned to grow and to protect democracy. We realize that democracy only grows or it dies. Democracy is never stable or stagnant. It is only vibrant or dying. Only we can make it vibrant. We believe that this alternative democratic structure, or whatever model the youth of the world and others choose, we believe it can comprise their own economy, society, and governments, which ensure self-determination for more of us world citizens each and every day. Maharishi Matthew, we believe that the world's youth and others must assume and they must demand a place of power and influence in their futures. They must impose their will upon the obsolete, corrupted current models.
That is sufficient for now. Who shall comprise these international online democratic nations?
Maharishi Matthew. All who embrace democracy as both a gift and a responsibility, they shall choose themselves as these citizens of their international online nations. At thelittlepenisthatcould.com, we envision a world of online nations where citizens are both committed to and yet not limited by the physical land and borders of traditional citizenships. Leaders of these international democratic online nations that cannot be bombed or invaded, they will be the examples of a vigorous democracy all across the world. The world's youth and climate activists shall earn, demand, and appropriate their rightful places of power and influence, leading the next generations as the champions of democracy and self-determinations all across the world.
That is sufficient for now. Why should someone desire to become a citizen of an Ion nation?
Maharishi Matthew, there are but two choices. You either get democracy or authoritarianisms. Those are the only forms of human governance and society. You either get free and fair democracy in forms of collaborative self-determinations, or you get authoritarian control and unfair forms of dominion where self-determination is largely absent. Right now in Russia, China, Iran, North Korea, and other authoritarian nations, they must maintain dominion over groups like women, Jews, people of color, indigenous peoples, climate activists, the youth of the world, and many others. They must maintain this dominion so as to remain in power. Most of all, they must weaken and destroy hope and the aspiration of self-determination. Democracy, the freedom of self-determination, is the only way for the oppressed and the marginalized to maintain self-determinations. There is no other choice.
That is sufficient for now.
And now, another one of our great commercials.
Buongiorno. There are many across the world who believe that we live within a fourth dimension and that all life is predetermined and that thus we have no control over what is happening. I asked my Swami Ashfaq, to share with the world his thoughts.
As you watch gorgeous George Clooney's tasty little penis sachet around your screen, relax, breathe deeply, and ask yourself, are you one of us, one of the men and women who stare at penis? I am Swami Ashfaq of the Church of the Untethered and Tasty Penis. The great philosopher and scientist David of the clan of the Mudhole, he believes and teaches that we all exist within a fourth dimension, where all life is predetermined and we are just along for the ride. At the Church of the Untethered and Tasty Penis, we, the men and women who stare at penis, some of us reject David and believe that we, with free will and responsible self-determination, we will choose to champion freedoms and democracy. Others of us believe that we cannot choose. We believe in this predetermined fourth dimension, where for some reason this fight for freedom and democracy has been chosen for us. As you watch gorgeous George's little penis gyrate across your screen, realize that according to David, you may have been chosen to join us as we ride gorgeous George's penis until freedom and democracy reign all across the world and internet. Bernard Shaw said, we do not stop playing because we grow old. We grow old because we stop playing. At the Church of the Untethered and Tasty Penis, we say, you may live long enough to change the world by playing with the penis. Stay hungry, my friends.
And now we return to Between the Two Penis with Maharishi Matthew.
When shall these Ion nations be birthed?
Maharishi Matthew, Our World Online. Ease now, our world everywhere. Life online must transition the state of a virtual realities to a manageable state of online reality. Online truth. Only then, when we control our online realities via various lenses and filters that we control and influence, and that are not imposed upon us. Only when we hold the keys to our online environments can we practice informed self-determinations. At thelittlepenisthatcould.com, we propose that the world's youth, people of color, women, indigenous peoples, Jews, LGBTQ, and all of the other lovers of democracy, we propose that we all unite, align, and govern, both online and possibly via universities worldwide. In this way,
we can all be integrating collaboratively with our local business, social, religious, and political fellow lovers of democracy. In pursuit of this self-determination, we also propose that the world join us today in convincing Gorgeous George Clooney's to sell his audaciously tasty little penis to fund charities and democracies all across the world. We at thelittlepenisthatcould.com, we believe that Ion Nations are inevitable, and thus today is when we should found them. What say you, Maharishi Matthew?
That is sufficient for now.
Would you like to say anything to the audience before we see you next week, Maharishi?
Dear Gorgeous George Clooney, ask not what the world and your country can do for your penis, but rather ask what your audaciously tasty little penis can do for the world and your country. Stay hungry, my friend, and share the penis.
Please join us next week for the conclusion of Between Two Penis with the Maharishi Matthew as we conclude the discussion of the who, what, when, where, why, and how of Ion Nations, International, Online, Socratically Democratic Nations. And now, a quick commercial about us. The Little Penis That Could, the podcast and the cartoon series, and our prank or plan to get millions of you all across the world to unite online for democracy, climate, women's rights, human rights, racial and LGBTQ rights, and the right of young people all across the world to actually be active effing participants in our world's economies, societies, and governments. Oh, and while we're at it, let's all unite and apply the needed economic, social, and political pressures to bring an end to the war in Ukraine. I mean, isn't that the very basic, decent, pro-democratic thing that all of us should feel compelled to do? To unite online and thank Ukraine as we help them by ending their war and using their nation and others across the world to relaunch our modern world in a new democratic direction. Look, we're dead serious. We hope you'll join us.
Buongiorno. Do world events have you concerned? Do you find yourself clenching your sphincter tighter than a skeeter's ass in a nosedive? My name is Dr. Gino Bartali, and this is my swami, Ashafak. Visit the Little Penis That Could, the podcast and the cartoon series, and catch our new shows every Thursday, where we think we can funk up democracies.
Before we exit, some of you may be questioning our desires to create socially beneficial economic models and businesses that are monopolistic so as to mandate maximum value to us as the proprietors and consumers of these businesses and marketplaces. In a world of international, online, Socratic, democratic nations, Ion nations, perhaps my Swami, Ashfaq, can enlighten us all in his show segment, Ruminations, or Chewings of the Pud, with Swami Ashfaq.
Socrates said, the secret of change is to focus all of your energy not on fighting the old, but on building the new. At the Church of the Untethered and Tasty Penis, we say, in order to change directions, one must point their penis where they wish to go. Join us next week and please consider our Patreon. Stay hungry, my friends, and share the penis.
If you enjoy our shows and mission, please support our Patreon. Grazie.